Hello, I'm Kurt David, host of the From Glory Days show, on location in Woodward Green Foods here in the city of Ferndale with our guest Lem Barney. Lem, we talked about that transition out of pro sports and some of the peaks of it, some of the challenges of it, stopping those dreams that you had for many years. One of the things that you did was had a chance to write a book about your life called The Supernatural, and this is a great book about Lem Barney's life, and certainly would recommend that you pick it up. It's available at Immortal Investment Publishers, is that correct?
Correct.
So again, it's called Supernatural, about Lem Barney's life. Lem, this is kind of a segment that I like about our show, that we have a live question and answer from our audience here. So if you're ready, we'll take our first question here.
Let's go get them.
If you wouldn't mind giving your name and then a question for Lem Barney.
Hello, my name is Scott, and I just want to say thank you, a comment and a question. Just thank you so much for being Lem Barney with the Lions. Whenever my friends, or we always talk, and there's Lem Barney, it's positive, it's pride. Growing up in the last 20 years, there's not much pride. So thank you for being who you are and what you've done to the Lions. It's needed and appreciated. My question was, we watched Barry Sanders walk away early. I wasn't around when you finished your career. What was the public reaction, or how did you handle it, and how did the media handle you walking away when you did?
Well, it's a good question. You did say Scott, right? Yeah, Scotty, thank you very much for your compliment there. But again, it was easy for me to walk away after I'd made the decision, after playing my seventh Pro Bowl, and then speaking with my wife particularly and my kids about the possibility of me leaving the game. And they were all in favor of whatever I wanted to do. So I think I could have played a few more years, but I think I made the best decision of my life to walk away from it at that time. I think Barry made a good decision as well. One thing about the game that people don't relevantly realize, in as much as a guy is great, even when he retires from the game, it only takes one play for a football player to end up as a Mike Utley, one for the thumb, or Daryl Stingley, paralyzed, or even a Chuck Hughes, who was my teammate that died on the field at Tiger Stadium. So I think the decision I made was first and foremost the greatest of my career.
Like we mentioned, able to walk away from the game on your own terms.
Absolutely.
Great. Next question.
Hey, my name is Rashard. I heard that you had some acting in your days. I wanted to know something about that.
Okay.
Actor, Lem Barney the actor.
Did you say Rashard?
Yeah.
Okay, Rashard, yes. I had the occasion also, not only having a gold record singing background with Marvin Gaye, but I starred in two movies as well. The first movie was called The Paper Lion. That was George Plimpton, who was a writer out of New York. He was a sports writer, and he ended up doing the Detroit Lions, called The Paper Lion, because he had four plays with the Detroit Lions. He wasn't a football player, he was a writer, he was an author, but he played four plays in St. Louis at Busch Stadium with the Detroit Lions as a quarterback. He had no skills at all, but the movie he wrote after the book stayed on the bestsellers list for 2.5 years, United Artists did the movie, and my rookie year, I was fortunate enough to be a part of the movie, did a lot of singing, but I was in drama in high school. And I mean, I tried to utilize all the skills that the Lord has given me. And then the other movie was called The Black Six. The Black Six was a motorcycle movie, and it was six African Americans who was in the war in Vietnam. And we signed a pact that if we survived the war, when we got back home, we would buy motorcycles and tour the country. And our motto was no hassle, peace and love. But everywhere we went, we encountered hassle. And the six guys who was in the movie, four of us now are Hall of Famers. Joe Green, Carl Eller, Willie Lanier, and myself, and other two was Mercury Morris from the Dolphins and Gene Washington from the 49ers. So use all the skills that the Lord has given you, okay, big guy?
Great question.
All right, God bless you. Thank you.
Let's take our next question here.
How you doing, Lynn?
Good.
My name is Charles, and I just want to know, what are you doing to give back to the Detroit neighborhood kids? Mentoring and things like that. Mentoring them and things like that.
Oh, yes, sir. Well, outside of everything we haven't mentioned, my greatest accomplishments and achievements to this date is 35 years in the ministry. I'm associate pastor at Hope United Methodist Church in Southfield, Michigan. So we have a lot of kids in our church, and we have a lot of kids that come to our church for various programs. So being a mentor is very easy. It's only giving back and sharing the ideas and the hopes and the dreams with others that you had, and inspiring them that they could dream big and dare to dream bigger and then accomplish and achieve those dreams. So whatever a child wants to do, we can do it, and there are people in the community will help them to succeed.
And that's a great way to give back. We didn't mention that. You're ordained minister now as a result.
Yes, sir.
So, great.
Yes, sir.
Well, let's take our last question for the segment.
Absolutely.
Here.
Absolutely.
Go ahead.
Hi, I'm Brian. I just want to know like what it was like to be alive.
Okay, your name is Brian?
Yep.
Brian's question was, what does it feel like to be a lion? It was one of the greatest feelings that one could really undertake after being an eight-year-old kid wanting to become a professional football player. And I had a lot of opposition with that at 8 years old because friends and family and educators alike told me I could never be a professional ball player because I was too small, I'd be too slow, I'd get creamed, I'd get smashed, think about doing something else. And I would come home crying to my mom and dad, and they would always tell me, don't ever fight back at a person when they tell you you can't do something you really want to do in your heart. But let it be, every time they tell you you can't do it, let it be like they're putting an extra gallon of gas in your tank to help you to achieve your goals. So by the time I got to Detroit in 1967, I was full of gas.
And full of joy as well.
Yes, sir.
Great answer, Lem. Well, one of the things that I know that you do, one of your goals is to bring joy on to people, and you certainly do that. Anybody that gets a chance to meet you in person understands the joy that you have in your life right now. It's been a pleasure having you on the show. Unfortunately, this wraps up another episode of our show. I'd like to thank our sponsors, Como's of Ferndale, Foley and Mansfield Law Offices, Freedom Hill Amphitheater, and of course the City of Ferndale for letting us have this great location today. And it goes without saying, I'd like to thank our guest, Lem Barney, for being on the show today. Please join us next time when we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
Underwriting provided by
Freedom Hill Amphitheater is one of Southeast Michigan's premier outdoor entertainment venues. Located at Freedom Hill County Park in Sterling Heights, Michigan, Freedom Hill offers a first-class entertainment experience. Find out more at www.freedomhill.net.
Como's Restaurant has been a Ferndale staple since 1961. Known for their deep dish pizza, this pizzeria's long menu includes breaded and fried appetizers, pastas, and 27 different meat specialties. Find out more at metrolive.com/Como's. The Ferndale Dream Cruise has been part of the Woodward Dream Cruise since 1995. As part of the 9 Metro Detroit communities involved with this historic event, the Ferndale Dream Cruise plays host to over 80,000 attendees every year and hopes you make downtown Ferndale part of your Dream Cruise experience. Find out more at ferndaledreamcruise.com. Foley & Mansfield is a national law firm providing legal expertise, creative solutions, and extensive trial experience for corporations, small businesses, and individuals. They're committed to result-oriented and cost-effective legal solutions to best meet the client's needs. Find out more at foleymansfield.com.